happily streaming on the rocket's red again, love's busting air. Through the night, that a flag was still there. Oh, say toss that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and home of the brave.
Colors, honor guard,
right shoulder, order,
arms.
I'm very pleased to introduce one of the FOP's strongest advocates in the House, former Sheriff Dave Reichert. Our friend is retiring this year from the House at the end of this Congress, and we wish him well, and we will miss you, sir.
Seated beside the sheriff is a very special guest for us.
The minority whip of the U.S. House of Representatives, a man that's been here many times, Steny Hoyer. It's also an honor to have with us another soon-to-be retiree, Paul Ryan, Speaker of the House.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
It's a pleasure to welcome you here, and we thank you for all of your support and work over the last years. Next to the Speaker is Linda Henney, National President of the FOP Auxiliary. She's with us, and she will have a few remarks in a few minutes. Turning now to my left, please welcome Paul Irving, Sergeant-at-Arms of the House of Representatives. Thank you.
judiciary. He proved to be a strong advocate for law enforcement officers and their families. His commitment to public safety helped him become governor of the great state of Indiana and then the vice presidency. Mr. Vice President, we are so grateful that you came to our service last year, and we are honored that you have come again to be with our survivor families. Please help me welcome the 48th Vice President of the United States, Michael R. Pence.
Mr. President, members of the cabinet, distinguished members of Congress, honored guests, members of the law enforcement community, and the precious families of our peace officers whose memory and sacrifice we honor today. It's an honor to be with you all. It is National Police Week, and I am deeply humbled. To join so many courageous men and women of law enforcement, and especially the families of our fallen, at this 37th annual National Peace Officers Memorial Service. You honor us by your presence here today. To the leadership of the Fraternal Order of Police, to all those who serve on the thin
get one breath, and it's what you're going to do with that. And we are so honored that you guys serve and protect us. We're grateful. We ask you, how will you spend your dash?
Well, 1990 2013 was written in granite above rest in peace. Those two little numbers with the line in between, it got me thinking about how much that little line means. Well, life goes by so fast, it sure does, and our story's defined by how we spend that dash. So take every breath like it's the only one you'll get, 'cause there's only so much breath you get to take. And when it comes to love, you can never give enough. So love like you mean it every day. From the first breath until
jobs. This past week, a bipartisan bill was introduced in Congress and voted out of the House Judiciary Committee by a unanimous voice vote. H.R. 5698, the Protect and Serve Act, will provide for federal penalties for those who deliberately target local, state, and federal law enforcement. We urge Congress to move quickly on this bill so that we can send a strong message that hurting a law enforcement officer is wrong. Nothing that we say here today can fix those wrongs. Nothing we say here today can fix broken hearts. But through our united voices and prayers, we can all commit to making sure that the souls we honor here today will never be forgotten. President Abraham Lincoln said, "In the end, it's not the years in your life that count, it's the life in your years." Those we honor here today gave their best years for all of us, and we are committing ourselves to making sure America remembers their service. God bless the families of our fallen heroes. God bless our law enforcement family. God bless our military for keeping us safe, and may God bless America. I am now honored to welcome and introduce the keynote speaker for our 37th annual National Peace Officers Memorial Service, Donald J. Trump, President of the United States. Mr. President, it is a great
Every American heart bleeds blue. That's for sure. This morning, I want to share with you, the American people, a few stories about the heroes we have gathered to celebrate and remember. With us today is the family of Lieutenant Aaron Allen, special, of the Southport Police Department in Indiana. His wife, Stacy, and his two sons, TJ and Aaron. Where are they? Where are they? Where are they? Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Lieutenant Allen was an Air Force veteran. After his service, he followed his childhood dream to become a police officer. He served in law enforcement for 20 years. No job was too great. No job was too small. He took extra shifts at night, and he was always available. He stopped by to say hello to members of his community. During Christmas time, he took children in need shopping for presents. He was always there for anybody that needed him. In 2015, he was given the Officer of the Year Award after saving two lives. Last year, Lieutenant Allen walked his son to the bus for his first day of kindergarten. Just hours later, Lieutenant Allen was shot and killed in the line of duty. Since then, the whole Southport community has come together to support the Allen family. And I hear that if you go to the police station, you'll find that six-year-old Aaron Jr. And he's up there, and he's giving orders, and he is respected and loved by everybody there. That is why, as I promised all along, that we are allowing local police to access the surplus military equipment they need to protect our officers and law enforcement agents and save their lives. And they are taking equipment at a record clip, millions and millions of dollars of surplus equipment is going to our police departments. If we want to bring down violent crime, then we must stand up for our police. We must confront and condemn dangerous anti-police prejudice. Can you believe this prejudice with respect to our police? We're not going to let bad things happen to our police. So we must show appreciation, gratitude, and respect for those who police our streets and patrol our communities.